Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. I am super excited because finally we have the ability to convert any animation created in Figma into an actual Lottie file, which can then be exported and given to developers, which can be put into websites easily on Webflow, Framer, everywhere. This video was made possible by LottieFiles themselves. So thank you LottieFiles for reaching out and partnering with me. Today we will be recreating this Twitter heart animation that you see on Twitter, even now on YouTube with a thumbs up. So, hit that thumbs up. I'll be providing relevant files in the description so you can follow along and do the same as I am. Now to make something like this, we will have to make sure that we have the final result with us and we can do everything in reverse. So everything is simplified, takes less than 5 minutes. So here, as you can see, I have this nice little circle. Now for a icon, I can always import any random icon I have from my favorite icon. Now I personally prefer phosphor icons. You can always get this plugin as well in Figma. And I've imported the iconic heart icon that you find on Twitter, the fat, podgy icon that I really love. Here, I'll make sure that it's the same pinkish, purplish color that is given on Twitter. Now, I will also create another layer here, which is the exact same circle, but this time we'll make it white. And I'll place it right behind the heart, like so. Now we have the heart icon placed in the center relatively, and we have the layer in the background. Now, we also need some of the confetti that they throw out when the heart pops out. So for that, I'll be making some smaller. So the key to this little animation is to have one small little circle here and one large circle right next to it. And the color should be somewhat similar to the green, maybe close to the green on the color spectrum. So something like a teal or a very light blue is fine. You can always duplicate these and rotate these. And that's about it. You'll just have to place these all around this and you'll probably have this animation ready in seconds. Now, for the sake of this video, I've just left the color to be exactly the same, but we're focusing more on the animation. Now, we have this basic structure ready. I'm not going to group anything together, so remember not to group anything. Otherwise, it can get buggy and it might not give you the result you require. And I will be going in reverse. For our final animation, I'll make sure that these circles are rotated towards the outside and are moving towards the outside as well. And I'll also make sure that these circles spread out like this. So it feels as if it's throwing the circles away. I have this nice little circle going all around and I'll make sure all of these are transparent so I can always make them 0% in the layer transparency here. I'll also be expanding both the white and the purple circles a little more so that they're expanded like this. And once they're centered, I will also reduce the opacity of this purple circle to 0 from the right. Now, as you can see, we have a final icon ready. For the previous animation, I will make everything visible once again, including the circles on the outside. For the previous animation, I'll make sure that the purple and the white are smaller, just like we had earlier, and it's visible, of course. I will also make all the circles on the outside visible once again by selecting just like this. 100% and everything appears perfectly. I will also be placing all of these closer to the circle as discussed earlier. Awesome. So we have like a second last and last animation ready. Now to make sure there's a seamless transition between this purple circle and here, we'll make sure that the purple circle becomes smaller in the second last animation. It sort of fits behind this little white circle. So it'll be a perfect hidden circle behind this. I think it's perfect. Now for the third last animation, I will make all these circles disappear once again. And of course, while I have all these selected, I will also make them smaller and kind of appear closer to the circle like so. Fourth last is even simpler. And make sure that the heart is very small because it's just appeared. And of course, I'll make sure that this white circle is also small relative to the heart right here, along with the purple being as large as it is. Before this, we will be making another heart. We'll make sure that the heart is really small and in the center and also invisible like everything else on screen. Now for the second animation, second set of animation, we'll make this circle even smaller, place it in the center and again, make it invisible. Now for the purple circle, I want to minify this as well a little bit. But in this case, I will want the purple to be slightly darker in shade. So something like this works for me. And the first one, of course, will be super tiny purple circle again, placed in the center, just like so. As you can see, we have a range of animation going from small, tiny circle, larger circle, then spreads out into a heart. Now, this is exactly how you should be making complex animations in Figma. And now we are going to convert this into a Lottie animation. Before we do that, we'll be using our trusty smart animation in Figma to finally make the animation come to life. So for the first, we will go ahead and click on the first frame, click on prototype on the top right here. And I will also add the flow starting point, which means that this flow is what we need to animate when we are exporting it. So interaction, yes, click on interactions. It will appear like this. Click on this click right here. And under this, instead of saying on click, I want to say after delay. Delay, you can give 10, 20 milliseconds or even as low as 1 millisecond. So I have 10 milliseconds and after this, I'll say navigate to. It will now navigate to frame 22 like we had displayed here. So choose frame 22 or you can always drag this arrow to the second one as well. Now we have instant to smart animate. Since we want it to be more in a single flow, we will make sure that instead of ease out, it is linear. And let's say about 100 or 150 milliseconds is a good quick animation. Same thing we will repeat for the second. Luckily, if we just drag this arrow, Figma repeats the animation. Now we'll do the same for all of these. And towards the end, I would love for a nice little bounce animation. Instead of saying linear, we can always say quick or bouncy, which is really cool. Before we get to export this, let's try it out in Figma itself by clicking on the little play button inside. And I want you guys to see how this real cool animation works out. See, it's such a nice, smooth animation, very close to what we see on Twitter. If you refine it more and make it more colorful and playful, it will look exactly like we see on Twitter as well. Now to export this finally into a Lottie animation, we are going to go to the resources tab on top, right here, top left. And click on LottieFiles, search for it inside plugins, and you will find this little LottieFiles plugin pop up. Of course, if you haven't logged in into LottieFiles yet, you can always do it from here, say log in. This will give you so many other features as well, and it's a huge benefit if you do. So inside this, you have your Discover tab where you discover all the cool animations other people have also built. So kudos to you, LottieFiles, for that. Workspaces, so if you have workspaces like I have going on inside LottieFiles, you can always import it to your workspace online so everyone in your workspace or team can see it. Now, I did run into a small problem with this animation while exporting. Make sure any element on screen is 100% opacity. In case if you want to hide something, just completely remove it from this frame as it is. Just delete it from the frame. If it doesn't have any importance in the frame, make sure that you delete these ellipses as well in the earlier frames. Now, when we run it inside the LottieFiles plugin right here, I can export to Lottie. And while I have this selected, I will click on Flow 1 as I've selected. And as you can see, this animation is now live right here. Of course, this was something I made quickly, so it's not fully refined truly. But if you refine it a little more, if you refine the animation, you'll be able to see the complete result right here. But for now, I think this is really cool. We can go ahead and save it to our workplace. I have this workplace created, Punit's workspace, first project, and I'll save it right here. You can always create a new project or a folder as well if you're wanting to create something. Quickly head over to LottieFiles, and inside your dashboard, you will have this nice little animation saved up here, right here. I have created other ones right here and exported it also. So if you have everything here in their dashboard, which I really like, you can always upgrade to their premium if you want unlimited files, you want unlimited folders and workspaces to work with. All right, so this is an experimental file provided by LottieFiles. I will give a link in the description so you can download and start playing with it. Let's figure out all the cool features provided inside this tool, all the cool features and animations which are possible using this little tool inside Figma. So for example, the first one I want to show you guys is this blob animation. So in this case, I will bring up my resource panel on the top. Inside this, I have LottieFiles right here on top. I'll click on run. And as you can see, it opens up, pops up like this. There is something called export to Lottie, which will actually show you the animation before exporting it. So make sure that the first frame is selected and click on export to Lottie. As you can see, this blob is transforming into this weird shapes. Imagine doing this with a blurred blob. You can create those blurred blob animations that you see in the background. You can even do icon path animations. So if you have a path based icon, the LottieFiles plugin will automatically detect this is a path kind of animation. And once you say export to Lottie, it will do the path animation. It will break down the paths and do different animations with it. So as you can see, it has some pre-made animations that you can access right here. I love this one. This is perfect for websites and apps. There are, of course, different kinds of animations that you can do with it. There are so many available here that from the time you download it, you can quickly just create animations. In this case, you don't have to even use Smart Animate or Figma features to animate this. And of course, you can slow down or speed this up. I like these details that they've given inside this. And of course, you can quickly save to your own workspace where you can have it as a LottieFiles, downloaded, edited on the LottieFiles workspace. There you go, saved. Again, this was super exciting to use LottieFiles plugin. It's finally possible to be able to export all our crazy Figma animations into a developer-friendly LottieFile. Now, developers cannot comment below and say, this can never be possible in production. I hope you like this video. Hit a thumbs up and also tell me in the comments if you like this plugin. I will see you next time. Same place, same time. Until next time, take care. God bless.